have a very eminent personality with us, Mr. Sachin Jain, who's the managing director of Forever Mark India. He's a very vibrant professional and a great thought leader for our jewelry industry. So thank you, Sachin, for joining.
Thank you, Sumesh bhai. You're always very kind, and thank you for your kind words. You're equally as dynamic, and we're all in this journey together. So thank you. Thank you for having me on this this conversation with you.
Wonderful. So Sachin bhai, so tell me something. Now this COVID-19 has swept the globe. And in terms of the fear in the health, in terms of the impact on the economy, I think the jewelry and diamond industry will not be immune. It will definitely be impacted. What is your assessment on the current situation?
I think first and foremost, Sumesh bhai, it's a monumental event. I think it's the way it's come across, the way it's hit all of us as humanity, has been unprecedented. We have never ever seen something like this. I mean, people talk about the financial disasters that happened in 2008, various other issues. But, even at those times, economic activity was going on. And who knows what happened when the big plagues happened in 1918 or things. So it's quite dramatic. I think I salute the Prime Minister of this country to take such a dramatic step. Because countries like America, which are so well ahead in the curve in terms of what they do and the infrastructure they have, and they're crumbling. Countries like Italy, Spain have crumbled. So I think we've been much better off. That's my initial feel. And I hope all your listeners are safe. The teams are doing well. And I think, Jaan hai to Jaan hai is a concept that Prime Minister Modi said. So I believe that. Now,
100%.
Keeping in mind what's the impact on the gems and jewelry business? Certainly, yes. I think I have a heart of retail. And I think in retail, one day shut is a day gone. So certainly that's sort of gone. And the only solace one can have is that in our category, consumers plan a purchase, right? You would buy, let's say, once in a year or two times in a year. But you plan that purchase. And with this shift for about a month or so, I expect consumers to, in some way, form, shape or size, come back. But there's a lot of work, a lot of thinking that we have as industry have to do in terms of giving the comfort to the consumer to come in. I mean, if today you're telling a consumer or any one of us that don't even go to a park because it's unsafe, what will happen on the 4th of May? 4th of May, why would a consumer walk into our stores and not feel unsafe? So I think it's a very important role that all the industry members have to play, that hygiene, controls, some sort of protocols have to be in place where consumers get that comfort that, our jewelry pieces are sort of cleaned by some protocols have to be done that we say we are on a free environment in some form.
Right. Sachin bhai, Forever Mark has a large presence in India today. What kind of a feedback you are getting from your trade partners, both in terms of the retailers and manufacturers after this, and what kind of an impact they are seeing on the business post-COVID-19 and this long lockdown, which is already we are 20 days up, and another 15 days more to go. So what kind of an feedback you're receiving from your trade partners?
See, I think, Sumesh bhai, since there's a lack of clarity as to when will we really open, and that sort of a thing was an issue. So hence, not so much clear everybody's on. But I think I know everybody, and I can salute to people who are leaders in this industry, who are bringing us up to skills and upping our game, that when it's time to go, we are all good to go. So the preparation that's happening, I see, is happening across the industry. It does not matter whether you're a very large scale player or you're a small enterprise. But I think you're really looking at what is the gap of skills, what I need to do for my teams, what I need to change. I think all those kind of discussions are on. So just getting equipped. But within the categories or within the industries, the different industries, I foresee that gems and jewelries comeback or recovery will be much faster than perhaps a lot of other industries. And there are various reasons I can say that, why that's going to happen. See, if I go in history of De Beers, and there are a lot of such occasions that have happened. I'll talk about two. First is, Japan, when the whole tsunami hit, 2008-09 or 2011-12. And that's when the entire country was shut down for over 4 months. They came back with a big bang in terms of diamond consumption. Not far, just China. January, February, complete lockdown. March, almost the 8th to the 9th of March, they opened this year. And March, in the world of Forever Mark and our partners, we've seen that they've done 70% against the budget. So it's unprecedented. The comeback is quite strong. Now, in our country, what's going to go for us is that the relationship that the consumers have with gems and jewelry is much more deep-rooted. You know, it's not a luxury purchase. It's something as an asset. It's something that you that people will certain, I believe, will come back faster. The things that will change will be design. I think the opulence will be gone. With all of us sitting in homes, you realize humility, you realize contentment, you realize the bit of fear of God. You know, all those things will get real. So, you know, I think that will also reflect in the way we will accessorize ourselves. And I think we need to be smart retailers or smart business people to work on your own designs and your offering. Because in this time when the consumers will start coming back, you know, we should not have big gaps to what we think that they will be coming to buy to what we're offering them.
Yeah, you mentioned very interesting that you have seen a kind of a strong bounce back in China, and the people kind of always been, you know, loving diamonds and the luxury products in China. But probably in India, our economy size and the GDP is not as comparable to China. And also you have daily wage workers, the farmers, the lot of middle class. So in that case, the general concern is that the essentials will definitely be the first one which will pick up and gradually down the line. So probably if we have a lockdown opening up from May, June and going down at least to Diwali, do you see the jewelry industry stabilizing this year?
I hope so, Smish Bhai. I think you're really right that once things open up, first people will look at your basics of life in terms of really getting back on track. I have been in touch with all my partners. And very interestingly, particularly the high-end retailers, there have been multiple examples where even in this lockdown period, consumers have booked some very interesting pieces, very high-value pieces. So, I mean, in the consumer set, there are a variety of consumer segments. So one is which will financially not get impacted by this lockdown. First and foremost is that, which I think is the lowest hanging fruit. We as a community need to work out ways and go back to them that we as an industry exist. The opportunity there is that if, let's say, somebody had a 25 years of their wedding anniversary, the fancy trip to Maldives is not happening. The guy is in a city. He's not going to go anywhere. We should take the advantage through our products to reach out to them. I think, you know, we should.
So there is the opportunity. Maybe the travel and the other fancy expenditure on, say, restaurants, eating out or gadgets, they'll be saving. So that could be a possibility of conversion into a jewelry.
Totally. It'll be because more than just the cost of all of this, the fact that you physically will be in a city and you will look at, you know, you are already a connoisseur, you like good things in life. So I think that's one segment. You're absolutely right that the bottom end of our society will not go through an easy sale because a lot of daily wage workers are there. Even look at jobs, for example. I think a lot of young workers in the industry, outside the industry, in variety of segments will have a bit of unclarity in the coming months. We need to be conscious of that. So I would say that, you know, there are two ways to look at it. One, really get boggled by that and worry and say there's no tomorrow. And I really believe that there's always business for somebody who wants to create that business. So we should look at, you know, within the segments where you should prioritize your energies in the first phase. Eventually things will, hopefully by Diwali, people will come back. But in this time, we all will have to do even more, reach out more to people, give them the comfort and go behind people who are ready.
Right. So for a company like Forever Mark, who's always believed in, you know, promotions, branding, positioning, and, you know, kind of is a luxury product. So do you see a company like you increasing your budgets post-lockdown, taking this as a long-term investment in investing more in branding and promotion and advertising? Is this something, can you share some thoughts on that?
Yeah, so Samantha, you've been in close touch with me and you witnessed, you know, last few years have been a dramatic response we've got from the Indian consumer, and we've been consistently advertising. As De Beers, in times which are tough, we believe marketing's role is even more critical. So for us, right now is a time when it's about marketing really doing its job, that consumers get, you know, are more enchanted towards our category. So first and foremost, you know, the fact that you're saying, will we be looking at this year, we will do all our best, we'll put our more energies into the market. you know, budgets, I don't see them, you know, going left or right. Budgets are clear. We will be going behind them. And there's been no discussion around those areas. Idea is that we believe as De Beers that it's a role of marketing now to do even a better job.
Right. So last couple of points. One is that what is your message for the Indian jewelry industry in this kind of a challenging times?
I think first and foremost, we now that we're all settled in after the 3 weeks, it's not a, you know, that sort of anxiety is settled. I think the next 3 weeks, make the most of them. I think up your skills, be in touch with your teams. You know, we talk a great deal about culture in the organization. You know, in De Beers, right, we have lots of values in the organization. This, my friends, is the time to play out those values and the culture of your organization, or a culture that you create as a leader. So your constant touch with your team, your upping your skills is extremely important. And I would say, you know, quantify it. And use this time, maybe 10%. 10% better on your physical health, 10% better on your consumer engagement, your marketing, your team. I mean, you know, just out of this lockdown, we should be better businessmen, better human beings. That's my only message.
Wonderful. And the last, my question is, how does Sachin Jain spend his day? Knowing you're an energetic person, so you must be keeping yourself occupied with some activities. Can you share
in the lockdown? It's been phenomenal. So I've been doing my long run in the morning. We, in the society that I live, they've still allowed social distancing run. So, you know, that's happening. Cool. So physically, all's going well. But, you know, we rolled out these training programs for our partners. So we have about 250 doors in India. Okay. We have these training programs, 11 of these training programs, right from finance to digital marketing to what we're seeing in media. We're doing one-on-one trainings with a media expert, how to face, you know, press. So stuff like that is happening. And these are back-to-back sessions with all our partners. So I've been very productively busy with all of this. And besides that, I think it's been a lot of fun. I mean, for someone like me, I've been, you know, really to have so much of time at home has just been magical. I'm loving it.
Exactly. So nice to hear that. And wishing you, Sachin Bhai, and your entire Forever team and your family all the very best, good health.
And thank you so much.
Thank you so much for your time.
Wish you the same. Wish your family the same, and all your listeners. You know, keep safe, and I'm sure we'll come out of this together much stronger.